Hello, friends! Welcome to day 20 of Illuminated Prayers. Dear friends, can you believe it's been 20 beautiful nights that we have been blessed with the opportunity to have direct access to immortal treasures, which will most definitely forever nourish our souls? How wonderful is that 20 days of vitamins for the souls, which will continue to strengthen us and bring all the more hope, all the more faith, all the more joy into our lives. And why not light, right, sunshine? As always, you are letting your light shine, beautiful friend. Welcome, sunshine, this little light of mine. I'm gonna let it shine, right? You're always letting it shine. Thank you for bringing your light into this realm and into our beautiful inner continental community, sunshine. Wonderful to be with you as always. And dear friends, our journeys through both realms in between heaven and earth have been really remarkable. This week especially, we have been able to see firsthand how motherhood is truly a blessing. Yesterday, our dear Marco beautifully presented to us the process of Julio's reincarnation, and we saw through Andre Lewis's wonderful lenses that the mother, Zumira, embraced him, Julio, the reincarnating spirit, ever so lovingly, that she was covered by a halo of light, and she looked like a Madonna, covered in beautiful, loving energy. Amazing, dear friends, how we have so many beautiful confirmations that we are divine in nature. Andre Lewis brings to us again and again the fact, indisputable, that we are meant to shine in the hands of God and through the love of our beloved Christ. Right, Ropinheiro? Thank you so much for your kindness, dear friend, beautiful child of God. Joyce, our beautiful mother, what an honor to have you here. Receive our loving hug, dear friend. John De Rosa, our eternal friend, is here. It's so beautiful to be amongst family, dear friends. Marco, our constant source of inspiration here. Thank you, Marco, so much for all the beautiful work that you have been doing. Fantastic to be inspired by you. Karina Lisi, our studious friend, acquiring treasures for immortality. Right, Karina Lisi, the unstoppable Karina Lisi. Beijos, dear friend. It's wonderful to be amongst you. We feel so blessed, dear friends, to have so many flowers of God blossoming right here before us. This is what spring truly is meant to be, the blossoming of such beautiful flowers, divine flowers such as yourself, each of you bring an ever more special perfume from the virtues of your soul that are a confirmation that Christ Jesus is definitely governing us and amongst us, dear friends. Thank you for being as divine as you are, right, Betsy? Wonderful to see you, dear friend. Thank you for being here with us. What a blessing. We feel super fortunate, so fortunate we can't even put it into words. So we will allow Andre Lewis to take the lead because he always does a fantastic job. So as our dear Marco explained to us in such an inspirational way yesterday, we saw Julio coming in his journey, dear friends, back to life. And we saw through Marco's beautiful explanation, Clarencius' prayer in honor of that reincarnating spirit. So we see time and again, dear friends, an untiring reverence to God in every account that we have the honor of studying together. We see this constant reverence, communion with God. We see the confirmation of what Andre Lewis reports to us in the book Evolution in Two Worlds. Andre Lewis reports to us that we are like fetuses, symbolically speaking, immersed in the amniotic fluid of God, which is the universal fluid. And just like a baby in its physical formation, like Julio yesterday, we are constantly connected to God through the umbilical cord of reincarnated life. How beautiful is that to know that God is surrounding us under all circumstances, right, dear friends? As the loving spirit, dear Diaz da Cruz, tells us in the book Pills of Trust, we are dreams of the Creator in the process of unfolding. How beautiful is that? Did you know, dear friends, that you are a dream of the Creator? Yes, you are. And speaking of dreams of the Creator, Andre Lewis reports to us that Julio is like a flower of hope blossoming in his mother Zumira's womb. And love, dear friends, as Marco explained to us yesterday, is so powerful and so transformative that Odila, Amado's first wife, who at first was so resistant to that second union, now, Andre Lewis reports, becomes almost like a guardian angel of that home. She is so lovingly grateful to the second wife now that she is expecting Julio in the physical body and allowing Julio to return to life, that she now embraces Zumira. Odila embraces Zumira. I'm going to bring the heart back again to our study. So Odila, who used to be separated from Zumira vibratorily, now unites herself in one heart with Zumira, watching over Zumira with the care of a mother, loving her and caring for her under all circumstances. Isn't it beautiful, dear friends, how love is transformative? No wonder our beautiful master recommended that we love one another. and that we reconcile with those whom we feel challenged by as soon as we can, as did Zumira and Odila. So now Julio had two mothers, believe it or not. Isn't that beautiful? A discarnate mother and an incarnate mother. So there was no loss, dear friends. The loss that Amado experienced and that Odila experienced and even Zumira experienced as Julio discarnated is sublimated, is transformed into a new life, literally. So there's always hope, dear friends. We learn through those bifocal lenses of life that Andaluz presents to us, that even in apparent loss, our hearts can still find hope, dear friends. Tonight we have a beautiful message of hope, because even when there is physical loss, God is so merciful that God allows the eternal bonds of love to be always there. And Julio literally is the living proof of it as he returns to life embraced by a mother in the discarnate realm and in the incarnate realm. So much love, right, dear friends? Beautiful, right, Soul Souza? You are so beautiful yourself, dear friend. Juliana Bonatis, I am so fortunate to see you yet again, dear friend. Big hug. Teresa Castro, always bringing joy to our world. Teresa Castro, welcome, dear friend. It's wonderful to have your joyous presence here with us. Welcome, welcome. So we see that Odila now is partnering up with Zumira. She no longer sees Zumira as an enemy. She was able to edit those difficult emotions, resignify them, transform them, and now embrace the good. This is why our dear Emmanuel proposes, seek the good, right? Visualize the good, mold the good with all the resources that you have at hand, and feel the good. This is the process that Odila was able to go through as she saw Zumira embracing the love of her heart, our dear Julio, right, dear friends? I'm glad you like the pink heart, Salt Souza. I am a true pinkaholic. That's a fact. All right. So, dear friends, we see Andre Luiz reporting to us that Julio starts to grow beautifully, dear friends, and that his new mother, Zumira, experiences some physical challenges, physical illnesses during the pregnancy. And our dear Andre Luiz, of course, asks why. Clarencio explains that it's because they are not mother and son in the same vibratory level, that they are not yet spirits that fully complement one another. But Zumira's acceptance and love for Julio is so great that is making the readaptation process easier for Julio. But Clarencio explains that often expecting mothers get a little sick because of the adjustment process, because Clarencio explains that their spirits are almost juxtaposed. How beautiful is this divine creation, allowing mothers to literally be mediums of life giving of themselves so that another spirit can intertwine with their own and they become almost one, spiritually speaking. What a beautiful act of charity, right, dear friends? Motherhood is true charity, to literally give of oneself. And as our dear Marco explained yesterday, it is during pregnancy that the perispirit adjusts to the body molecule by molecule, and it is the mother's perispirit that guards this process. How beautiful is that, right, dear friends? Lovely in so many ways. It's so beautiful that it almost transcends our ability to express it into words. So our dear Julio, says Andre Luis, is reborn, dear friends. And Zumira, who used to be jealous of him prior to this new reincarnation, becomes truly devoted. Once again, dear friends, we see Andre Luis reporting a complete transformation of the heart. How? What is the password there? Two passwords: love and charity. And motherhood, as Andre Luis is beautifully describing to us, is one of the most profound forms of charity. For a mother's perispirit is literally juxtaposed with the reincarnating spirit's perispirit. And a mother literally gives of her vitality and her life prior to that baby being born to sustain that life. The mother literally embraces the child in every moment. So the password for transformation is love and charity, and motherhood is a beautiful example of that. So our Julio, dear friends, is beautifully reborn, and there is joy experienced in both realms by Odila and Zumira, the two mothers who now live in harmony. But do you remember, dear friends, that our Marco explained to us yesterday that Julio had a little bit of reincarnatory baggage, so to speak? That is, he had his shoes from previous choices that he had made that had to be redressed in this new life. Do you remember this? Thank you, Marco, for explaining it so beautifully yesterday. Teamwork effort, right? So, yes, so he had issues that he had to redress. He had taken his life away previously. So in this new life, his life would be cut shorter so that he would learn to value the gift of a physical body. So because he took his life away previously through poisoning himself, he has a congenital illness on the throat, dear friends. This is because his perispirit carries marks of those previous actions. So what that tells us is that he is more predisposed to developing physical illnesses because of the vibratory charge that is connected, that is imprinted particularly on his throat. So because of this negative vibratory charge, he developed a severe illness still as a child. Hello, dear Daisy, flower of the garden of our hearts. Thank you for being here. It's a gift to be with you, dear friends. Thank you so much. Appreciate a big hug. Yes, so he develops a newness when he's still very little. So Zomira gets desperate, even though she already knew that he would discarnate soon, early on, and she had accepted that plan, as Marco explained yesterday. She still struggled, of course, which is understandable. Odile, his mother in the discarnate realm, also struggled. So they both called in Clarencio, André Luiz, Hilario, all the spiritual team back. And they inspired Zomira and Evelina, the sister, and Amaro, the father, to call a doctor. The doctor is Mario Silva. Mario Silva and Zumara had an affair in at a late earlier point in their lives, and they had broken up. So the doctor, Mario Silva, feels this instinctive rage against the Zumara, Amaro, and Julio's family. He recognizes instinctively that they have unresolved issues from the past. So instead of open-heartedly treating Julio in that moment of sickness, Mario Silva is very reserved, and he decides not to be as helpful as he could be. Meanwhile, we see Mario Silva, the doctor, treating another patient almost simultaneously. And the other patient is the very child who said our illuminated prayer 2 days ago in the God at Home. Do you guys remember that God at Home whose prayer was said by a child? That very child was also sick and was also treated by the same doctor. André Luiz shows that the doctor feels love and care for that one family, while he feels repulsion for Zumira, Amaro, Julio, and Evelina. So he refrains, he stops himself from treating Julio very carefully. And even though he knows that as a doctor, he is supposed to embrace all patients, right, Marco and Joyce? As you do, I am positive. He was not able to do so because his instincts from a past life spoke more loudly. So what happens, dear friends? Our dear little boy, Julio, once again is about to embark upon the big transition. He's about to leave his physical body yet again as a result of an illness due to having committed suicide previously. And at that very moment where he's about to transition again to the spiritual realm and become a discarnate spirit, his father, who is very devoted, Amaro, dedicates a beautiful prayer to his soon-to-be discarnate son, Julio. So this will be our illuminated prayer of tonight, the prayer of a devoted father, of Julio's father, who is about to watch his discarnation once again. So let us open our hearts with love and respect and decide to follow Julio's father, Amaro, with all the devotion that he expresses. Let us try to feel that same love and devotion in understanding God's design Because as Marco beautifully explained yesterday, God is good. And as a beautiful Lord of life, God is always just as well. So let us be inspired by this devoted father's prayer as he teaches us how to accept God's will even in such challenging circumstances. Right, friends? So if you would like to accompany us word for word, we are going to chapter 32 of the book Between Heaven and Hell, pages starting on page 211. We are right here in between heaven and hell, heaven and earth, excuse me, chapter 32. So here we go. This is our illuminated prayer, dear friends. The dawn was beginning to reflect itself in the sky in broad red streaks when Amaru abandoned his thoughts and approached his almost dead son. With a moving gesture of faith, he took an old wooden crucifix off the wall and put it on the nightstand beside the dying child. Then he sat down on the bed and took the boy on his lap with special tenderness. So before we continue, let us imagine this scene, dear friends. This child is about to pass away for the second time in a short time, but God is so loving that God allows the same father that had embraced him previously to embrace him yet again, so that even in this moment of great transition, we see the spiritual and loving ties that are eternal being re-solidified yet again. So we see love transposing all the mountains that are before them, right, dear friends? In this case, the mountain that we are referring to is the mountain of physical death. We see in the loving gestures, in the body language of this father, that we, through love, can juxtapose the symbolic mountain of physical death. That for someone who truly loves, physical death is not an obstacle, because love will surpass the temporary vibratory difference between an incarnate spirit and a discarnate spirit. Right, Rita de Cássia? Thank you for the gift of your presence. Thank you, dear friends. So let us observe the body language of the Father a little more closely before we move on to the actual prayer. André Luiz reports that he takes a wooden cross. So what does that show us, dear friends? That even in a moment of great distress, he puts his life in the hands of our Master Jesus. Symbolically. So, therapeutic question for us. When we are experiencing distress, do we remember to ask for support for our Master Jesus? Do we believe that our Master Jesus can and is beside us? Let us be inspired by this loving Father and trust that our Master Jesus shall be by our side. Shall we, dear friends? Let us too, together, symbolically, take our Master with us and place him in our heart, shall we? Yes, we shall, right? So this is the first observation that we would like to make regarding the Father's body language. The second observation is that he sat down on the bed and took the boy on his lap with special tenderness. So what does that show, dear friends? That even though the body is disconnecting from the spirit, and he knows that the child will no longer be able to manifest in ways that are physically intelligible, the Father believes in the genuinity, in how genuine his love is for his son, so much that he still embraces the child and puts him on his lap, kind of saying without words, I am here for you, I love you, and I shall always protect you unconditionally. So the Father is saying without words that not even physical death shall separate us, because look at how close you are and you will always be with me. So for sure, dear friends, this act of tenderness will be registered in Julius' perispiritual brain and heart. And this shall be like a vitamin for his soul as he continues on his journey. So we see that both child and father realize emotionally that they will not be separated despite the physical separation. How beautiful is that? Therapeutic question number two for us. Are we willing, ready, and able to resignify the meaning of physical death for us? Are we willing to see those who die physically as just a body which has died? Are we willing to see the spirit as alive as it always has been, even after death? Have we been able to compute that we are eternal spirits and that death is just a transitory and temporary change? Let us revisit our concept of death, right, dear friends? Because this is why we are in the school of life, to re-signify the old conditionings that we may have brought with us from previous lives. Thanks to Spiritism, we are no longer imprisoned by fear of death or fear of separation, because thanks to the accounts from between heaven and earth, we know that they don't exist, that those old conditionings are but a temporary illusion. So we can affirm to ourselves, I free myself from old conditionings. Three times. I choose to free myself from old conditionings. Third time. I choose to free myself from old conditionings. Beautiful. Let us continue now. Now we can move to the prayer itself. But before we do, we would like to point out that Odila, Julius' discarnate mother, is also embracing Julio and the father. So we see multidimensional love and unity being displayed through body language here. So let us picture right now we ourselves receiving a multidimensional embrace by the mentors that are connected to our family, by our guardian angels, by the mentors that are in our spiritual network, by the mentors of Kardec Radio. Let us breathe in and out and feel this multidimensional embrace, understanding, dear friends, that like Julio, we are never alone, even in moments of transition, right? We are not alone. We are not alone. How beautiful is that, right? So let us now, knowing that at this very moment we are receiving a multidimensional embrace, let us embark upon our illuminated prayer of tonight. Amaru says, Divine Jesus, have mercy on our weakness. My spirit is too fragile to deal with death. Give us strength and understanding. Our children are yours, but how it pains us to have to give them back when your will demands their return. How beautiful are those words, dear friends. The Father is not afraid to show his fragility. He is talking to our Master as if our Master were a friend, a divine friend. So the Father, beloved friends, is not wearing any masks, is not following any conventions, is not pretending not to feel what he's feeling. Rather, he's having a truthful conversation with our Master without feeling any fear of showcasing his difficulties. So therapeutic quiz for us. Are we able to talk to our Master and expose our own inner difficulties to him? Are we able to call our Master Jesus our divine friend? So, heart work for all of us, including myself, as we propose to the children at the Spiritual Society of Virginia, right, Daisy? We don't give them homework. We give them heart work. Because as spirits, we are molding our hearts to better serve God on earth. So heart work for us, dear friends. Shall we open our hearts at any moment in the next 24 hours and speak to our Master, addressing him as our divine friend? Shall we please open our hearts to the Master and expose our inner joys and inner difficulties to him as if we were having a conversation with our best friend? Shall we, dear friends? I look forward to having a conversation with our Master. Do you? We hope so. So let us continue our illuminated prayer. He says, Amaru says, our children are yours. How beautiful. So he's already an awakened spirit, dear friends. Amaru is aware that even though our children come back to life through us, we are their tutors. We are the ones that God entrusted them to as treasures, but we are not their owners. They are not our property. So at any point in time, we will return them to the real father, mother, of all of us, who is God, right? So beautiful. Another heart work for us. Are we able, ready, and willing to look as though at those whom we love as children of God? Shall we call the ones we love, dear friends, children of God mentally? Tomorrow, shall we? In the next 24 hours? Yes, more heart work for us, so that our heart connects with the Master's all the more, right? Yes. So let us continue. Tears interrupted his voice, but displaying his urgent need to pray, wow, even in distress, Amaru felt an urgent need to connect to the Master. Beautiful. And so he continued, if it is your will for our son to leave us, O Lord, receive him into your arms of love and light, but grant us the courage we need to bravely bear our cross of longing and pain. Wow, how beautiful. So he recognizes that God is love. So he beautifully handles his child to the arms of love and light of God and asks for courage to fulfill God's will. Beautiful. Another heart work for us in the next 24 hours, dear friends. We have three heart works so far. Number one, speak to Jesus in the realms of our hearts, calling him our divine friend. Number two, look at those whom we love as children of God. And number three, ask God for the courage to fulfill his, her will. How beautiful is that, right? Because God is so good. God is so good. God is so good. So good to us, right? Yes. And Amaru continues, give us resignation, faith, and hope. Help us understand your purposes, and may your will be done now and forever. What a lesson, dear friends, for all of us to be inspired to accept God's will, especially when God gives us what we need rather than what we want, because it's not every day all the time that what we need matches what we want. Why is that? Because God has a multidimensional perspective on us. God knows from our previous old conditionings to the goals we would like to accomplish now to the future that we deserve. So God knows us from the past perspective, present perspective, and future perspective. And even better, God knows what we would like and what we deserve to achieve. God sees us as his, her perfect creation. So God says, allow me to give you this remedy for your soul here. It may not taste very good right now, but it will enable you to get to me even faster than you would otherwise, because I love you. So how about, dear friends, if we learn little by little by little by little to resignify pain as a sign of God's love? Yes, because God is good, so God is not punishing us. God is instead offering us the opportunity that we need, the remedy that we need to propel us forward even faster, right? Because God trusts our ability to grow and progress. How beautiful is that? So thank you, God, for giving us what we need rather than what we want, because literally you know better than we do. So true, right, Souza? Thank you, Rudy, for the gift of your presence, always bringing light to all of our lives. Thank you, dear, dear friend. So, thankfully for us, dear friends, André Luiz describes what happens during the prayer and as Júlio discarnates. André Luiz says, streams of sapphire light flowed from Amado's chest to envelop the child. Beautiful sapphire light from Amado's chest. Why the chest? Because the chest is where our coronary chakra is, where the home of our emotions are, and the father feels true love for that child. So literally his heart is going out to the child energetically, and that beautiful child, our Julio, is taking his father's love with him. How beautiful is that, right, dear friends? The heart really has beautiful transformative powers. And to end our prayerful moment in a beautiful note, we pay homage to all mothers yet again, because André Luiz describes that as Julio disengages from his physical body, he finds shelter in his mother's Odila's arms as an orphan seeking shelter, eager to be comforted. So God is so great, dear friends, that God offers us loving arms in the incarnate realm and in the discarnate realm as well. So even when we ourselves take the great journey, we have absolutely nothing to fear, for we know that we shall be embraced by love, through love, and with love always. Right, dear friends? Beautiful. Shall we say a closing prayer of gratitude for these beautiful acts of love that André Luiz registered for us? Shall we? Beautiful God, creator of life in all dimensions of the universe, we thank you for the opportunity to study together, because yet again, we have loving, real life, eye-opening accounts of how your love is so abundant that it reaches us in no matter what dimension we find ourselves. Thank you for showing us yet again that your love is limitless, unbounded, and ever-present. Thank you for showing us, dear Mother, Father, God, that a mother's love goes beyond any barrier, as does a father's love as well. If our love for each other is as great as it is, we don't even dare to imagine how wonderful and grandiose your love must be. But we happily, Mother, Father, God, surrender to your love, though we don't fully comprehend it, asking you that this love guides us all in every decision we make. Let us learn to be useful in your loving hands, because through you we know that love shall prevail under any circumstance. Thank you for our Master Jesus, who guides us, supports us, and loves us unconditionally because of you. Thank you for Andre Luis, constantly nourishing our soul. Thank you for the blessed mediumship of Chico Xavier. May Chico Xavier receive flowers of gratitude from all of us. Thank you for our Kardec Radio community. And thank you for the professors in the beyond that inspire us all in this sacred hour of learning and transforming ourselves for the better. With your permission, Mother, Father, God, we close our studies tonight, and so be it. Thank you, dear friends. God bless all of you, dear friends. Thank you so much. We will end with a beautiful song to inspire our hearts, right? Because Saul Souza is telling us, for sure, God knows best, and God knows the reason for our suffering. That's for sure. Great. Our hearts are also full of love for God and for our divine friend. Shall we sing in honor of our divine friend? Jesus is passing by. Jesus is passing by, and when he comes, everything is fine. Sadness is gone, and happiness arrives. And when he comes, everything is fine. Sadness is gone, and happiness arrives. Let us all feel the joy of living that our Master's presence brings us, dear friends. Many, many beautiful blessings and a beautiful night of sleep for the good, shall we, dear friends? Big hug and many kisses. Bye for now.